My name is Anne-Marie Fink, and our laboratory is part of the Center for Narcolepsy, Sleep, and Health Research. And this is a laboratory that's in the College of Nursing. And so that gives a unique background to our laboratory work. So most of the faculty have a background in nursing or some other kind of clinical specialty. And I really think that's a huge strength for us because it allows us to see the big picture. I should also say our group studies sleep disorders. And as nurses, we know a lot about what's in the clinical area in terms of sleep disorders, but research is certainly lacking in that area. I was always interested in science, and I chose to go into nursing because I really wanted to work in hospitals, and that work had always fascinated me. And so I worked for several years, went into the military almost immediately after finishing nursing school, and then did that for several years. And this is where my interest in sleep really started to come about. When I was working in an intensive care unit, and I saw that there was an unmet need for understanding disorders related to sleep. And fortunately, I had great opportunities to pursue training for graduate school. And everything fell very nicely into place where I had the opportunity to study in labs that were examining sleep and cardiovascular function, and then that came together for me with the opportunity to have this laboratory at the University of Illinois and work with a top-notch team, all nationally renowned sleep researchers. So I think for me that's really where the interest sparked, that I just saw that there was something that the world didn't know, and I wanted to be a part of solving those puzzles, solving those problems. What I'm interested in understanding is why people who have sleep apnea syndrome develop high blood pressure. And sleep apnea is a huge public health problem. People who have this condition have a high likelihood of developing increased blood pressure, and they are at increased risk for stroke. And so my work is focused on understanding the brainstem connections that play a role. An important factor in sleep apnea is that there tends to be an overactivation of the sympathetic nervous system, and it's thought that this may play a role in why people develop elevations in blood pressure over time. If I know the function that I believe those neurons have, I could stimulate them and then see, for example, do I get an increase in blood pressure? Do I get apnea, which is a pause in breathing? So do I get the function that I believe those neurons have? And then when I study the tissue later, I can leave dyes or marks in there and then find that site where I had been and link that. I can link the function with the anatomy. It's interesting because my work is in laboratory animals, but all of the work that we're doing is to lead up to better treatments for people. And the treatments that exist today, and specifically for sleep apnea, are limited and people find them difficult to tolerate. And the work that we're doing, I think, will lead to a more innovative approach. Particularly the work that I'm doing in the brainstem is important for delineating these pathways that could be altered by drugs or other interventions to improve outcomes. I would say my ultimate hope is just to disseminate new knowledge. So new knowledge of how the brain works and how sleep works, and these are things that people just don't understand very well. Because something that keeps us alive and is responsible for all of our basic functions, whether that be sleep, breathing, digestion, all of those things, we just don't really know a lot about it. We don't know a lot about all the different areas in the brainstem and how they play those roles together. So I think that would make a huge mark on science to just have more information about that physiology. I do. I would say I like it more every day. And there's certainly aspects of it that are work, such as publishing your results and getting the experiments set up. But at the end of the day, you've achieved something and you've discovered something and you have something new, and that part of it's very exciting.